Trust her?
Will I get hurt?
Oh. Hello.
Hello.
I discreetly appraise her appearance.
And conclude that for a woman of my desperation, passes my absolute appearance minimum.
And I give a positive approval, although noting facial imperfections. That's a lovely blouse. I blindly compliment her choice of apparel.
Thank you.
I thank him, knowing he couldn't care less, and return the compliment.
That's a nice tie.
Oh, thanks.
Which I don't mean, just to be polite.
Awkward silence.
Awkward silence.
Isn't this place great? I love it.
No. More than that. I love it.
I utter a clever, ice-breaking remark.
Yeah.
He says something stupid.
Was that stupid?
And we discuss pertinent information.
So, you're in publishing.
I track international marketing strategies. You?
Well, I do R&D for a blackboard manufacturer. We make blackboards and blackboard accessories.
Uh-huh.
You live in a one-bedroom?
Studio. You?
Oh, one-bedroom and a small office.
You like living alone?
It's okay. What floor is your studio on?
Basement.
Oh.
It's a big studio, though.
I'm sure.
A lack of light can be debilitating.
Awkward silence.
Awkward silence.
I stare into my menu.
I avoid making eye contact.
Because I have nothing to say. And then we discuss our mutual friend who set us up.
Did you know Ellen left for Pakistan?
She is incredible.
I didn't even know she spoke Pakistanese.
And three others besides.
Amazing. She went to treat cows for this disease.
Yeah, she mentioned she was working on a vaccine.
She cracked it in 2 days and left.
She told me that she'd have to parachute in because of the jungle.
The jungle. The cows in the jungle.
She's incredible. Cows.
She'll save them.
If anyone can.
I say,
I'm thirsty.
And I can't think of any potential conversation when, luckily...
So, I'm at this party at Random House. All bigwigs, see? And I start telling this guy about one of my ideas. One of my nonfiction ideas. About how George Eliot is really a man. Pretending to be a woman, pretending to be a man. And how I researched the diaries. And we hit it off.
He talks about himself for a half hour.
My novel.
He drops some names.
Not Deloise.
Tells me what they did together.
Art opening.
And who they ran into.
Connie Chung! Isn't that weird?
Of course not. But I give a false laugh.
Followed by...
banal chatter.
Banal chatter.
Banal chatter.
Banal chatter.
Banal chatter.
Banal...
We pause as...
I pour the water.
Because we don't want him...
to overhear...
our banal chatter.
Banal chatter.
I'm about to excuse myself to use the bathroom. Never to return, of course, when...
So, I'm leaving my apartment this morning, and I go to get in the elevator. And my bag, my new bag, my Christian Dior bag that I got for myself for a present, you know, for finishing this very difficult paper I was writing for this Women in Literature night class I was taking. And the bag gets
caught.
She
tells some long and pointless story.
So I can't get the bag loose. Blah, 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 blah.
I carefully place interjections to feign interest.
Blah, blah.
Yeah.
Blah, blah.
Wow.
Blah, blah.
Yowza.
Blah, blah, blah.
All the while wondering if it's obvious that I'm barely paying attention.
You didn't listen to a word I said.
Blah 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 blah.
Getting the highlights, but missing the point completely.
What point? What are you going to get?
I don't know.
I feel uncomfortable, knowing I wish to be someplace else.
Wondering why she doesn't like me. Self-doubt.
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 So I conjure up a dozen airtight excuses of why I suddenly have to leave.
But I don't say anything.
I think of... how long it's been.
I think how lonely I feel.
How tired I am.
Of being alone over here.
When I could be over there.
And I wonder if a person of my romantic desperation should act like this. More self-doubt.
Oh, I'm pathetic.
Because I know how being alone is very...
boring.
Would you like some bread?
Yes, thank you.
I lean forward.
Becoming interested
in what she has to say.
We begin to talk about our childhoods.
We exchange parental divorce stories.
I was 9.
I was 10.
And as we speak...
about our childhoods...
I feel more relaxed.
And I have...
so much to say.
That we say the same thing at the same time.
I tell her to go.
I tell him to go.
And we... Do it again!
Followed by...
witty banter.
Witty banter.
Witty banter.
Witty banter.
I make a suggestion to continue at a location of... decreased population?
Enthusiastic compliance.
As we signal the waiter for the check.